Welcome to V+U Academy. My name is Ashish Garg and today we are going to see the previous year questions of kinematic indeterminacy of the structure. In the last class, we have seen the kinematic indeterminacy of the structures. On the same page, we will be doing kinematic indeterminacy of the structures and its previous year questions that is asked in the IES exam and the GATE exam. Basically, from as you know, degree of kinematic indeterminacy refers to the number of unknown displacements and slope rotations. So if you have given any structure and you will be able to find out the number of unknown displacements, this will give you the value of kinematic indeterminacy of that particular structure. So let's start with our today's topic, that is calculation of value of kinematic indeterminacy of structures. Now we know that dk is given as number of unknown displacement. It is the number of unknown displacements and rotations minus number of rigid spokes. For example, to understand this definition, if we have given this frame, let's say we have this frame, this is called as one-way portal frame. Sometimes they will ask you to find out the kinematic indeterminacy of this frame. So as we know, this is the kinematic indeterminacy is the number of unknown displacement and rotation. If I say this point A, B, C and D, now at any point you will get three unknown displacement in the plane frame. If you have a space frame, you will get six unknown displacement. And how is so? The three unknown displacement you will get is delta x, delta y and the value of theta, that is in z direction. So these are the your three unknown displacement in a plane frame. So at any point, let's say B point, you will get these three unknown displacements. So if we have these three unknown displacement at point B, similarly we have these three unknown displacement at point C also. So total we have six unknown displacement. But at A point, if I say at A point, we have zero unknown displacement because we have theta value at A point, that is fixed spot, which is equals to zero. Similarly, we have delta x value and delta y value at point A equals to zero. If I write down in A here, these are equals to zero. So similarly at B also, we have these value equals to zero. Now how to calculate the unknown displacement in this structure? You know at B and C you have three unknown displacement at this point and three at this point. You have total of six unknown displacement. But as you can see, as we have this fixed spot, if we derive the equation of compatibility, if we see the equation of compatibility in this structure, compatibility means you have something common in that structure. For example, in this structure, you know that delta A or delta X A and delta Y A equals to zero. That is, in X direction, your displacement zero, and in the Y direction, you have zero displacement. So at point three, you will get delta, at point three, you will get delta X B and delta Y B. You get delta xb, delta yb and theta at point B. Similarly at point C, you will get delta xc, delta yc and theta at point C. So if you see here, if the delta x value, if I draw its deflected shape, something like this. Now you can see here that this is its delta x times of b. and this is its delta x times of c. But we do not get any delta y value at point B. That is equals to 0. Why? Because we have delta ya equals to 0. This is the reason we will get delta yb equals to 0, as we know that this is the rigid support. And in case of rigid support, you have to maintain this angle. You have to maintain initial and final angle. If your initial angle is 90 degree, then you have to maintain this final angle also. If you change its length, say if you provide this structure like this, if your structure is like this, then this shows there is a change in length equals to this magnitude, which is not possible. That's why we have delta yb value equals to 0 in this point. So we have this value equals to 0. Similarly, here also we do not have any delta y. Delta y at point C also not there. So we have delta yc also equals to 0. And from here you can see the value of delta xb should be equal to value of delta xc, because we consider this beam as a rigid beam, and if this beam is rigid, then that means there is no deflection in that beam. So that means your delta xb should be equal to delta xc. So you have now three compatibility equation, number 1, number 2 and number 3. So as we can see now, if we calculate our kinematic indeterminacy here, you have the 6 minus 3, that is 3. Your answer will be 3. So number of unknown displacement in this case are 3. So on the same note, the questions that is being asked in the UPSC is in much details. For example, now I will be telling you the question only, and I will try to give you the solution only, so that you understand the type of questions asked in the exam. So the question that is being asked in the UPSC is, if you have given this fixed port and you have given this a hinge beam, another hinge is also provided, a roller support is provided. If this point is A, B, C, D, E and F, say here you have an internal hinge, you have been asked to find the value of kinematic indeterminacy of this structure. So try this question. Now how can you solve this? You know that due to internal hinge, you have one extra unknown displacement, that is due to theta. I will suggest you to write down all the unknown displacements and unknown rotation of any structure that you want to calculate its degree of kinematic indeterminacy. So at point B, if you calculate the unknown displacement and rotation, you will find that you will have theta B, delta BX and delta BY. That is deflection in X direction and the deflection in y direction. Similarly, but at this point you will get delta value at, say, joint. This is our joint or hinge support, you can say, but you get theta jb and theta jc. That means it will deflect at different angle. Here it has different angle, and here it has different angle because it is internal hinge. So that will be our different angle, and similarly here also we will have the delta value we have seen in the vertical direction, and delta value we will have in the horizontal direction. So these are the four unknown displacement at this joint. Similarly, you can find out at this point, that is theta c, delta cx and delta cy. Here also theta e, delta ex and delta ey. Here we have theta d and here we have theta f and delta fx, because your delta fy is 0 in this case. Now find the compatibility condition. Find compatibility condition Once you find the compatibility condition, you will be able to tell the value of kinematic indeterminacy of this structure. Now, you know unknown displacements are, if you count all the unknown displacement, you will get this is 3, then we have 4, 7, 10, 13, and 13 plus 2 plus 1, that is 16. You have total of unknown 16 displacement. But with the compatibility condition, and if you have given this, if members are, you have also given, if members are inextensible, members are inextensible, that means the length of member cannot change. If members are inextensible, then find the value of degree of kinematic indeterminacy. Now you will say that, now will you directly say that your value of delta by will be equals to 0. Similarly, you can say your value of delta cy equals to 0, and similarly delta ey will be equals to 0. So these are the compatibility condition that you already know. So if we see in the horizontal direction also, you can say your compatibility will be delta bx should be equal to delta times joint in the displacement in the horizontal direction, that is this value delta jx, then it should be equal to delta cx and delta ex. So if I write down all them delta h, that is deflection in horizontal direction, you can neglect any three. By knowing any one value, you can neglect any three values, because with the help of this value you can calculate all the values. So three compatibility condition we have here: delta cx, delta bx, delta ey, and delta x. So we know three compatibility condition here, and three we already know, so it makes it 6, and the answer will be degree of kinematic indeterminacy equals to 10. So this is the another kind of question that is asked in the IAS examination, or you will find that kind of question in GATE examination. So moving to our third type of question, the question from the third part, if I tell you the question from the third part, the question asked from the third part is, if you have given this beam, if you have given this structure, if you have given this structure, say this structure, now you have to again find the value of kinematic indeterminacy of this structure. Now you have one formula also with the help of which you can find out the kinematic indeterminacy, that is dk for frames is given as 3 times of number of joint minus number of spot reactions, that is j is the number of joints and r is the number of spot reaction. So in this case we can see we have 9 joints, that is if this is A point, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and I, then you will find that we have 9 spots and 9 joints, and if you calculate the number of spot reaction, you will find here we have 3 spot reaction, similarly here we also have 3, but here 2. So we have total of 8 spot reactions. If you put these values in this case, we will get 3 times 9 minus 8, that is equals to 19. You will get 19 number of indeterminacy. But in the question you have given that the members are inextensible. If you have given these members are inextensible, if members are inextensible, that means the length of member cannot change. In that scenario, the formula become, now the new formula will become equals to d times k equals to 3 times j minus r minus m. That is, m is equals to number of inextensible member. Number of inextensible members. So this will be our new formula. This will be our new formula, and if we solve by this formula, we will get 3 times 9 minus 8 minus, if we calculate the number of member, we will know 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total of we have 10 members, and if we solve this, we will have 9 number of unknown displacements and rotation. You can do this simply by here also, by writing down like this, theta b, theta c, delta cx, delta bx, similarly here also, theta e, delta ex, and theta a, delta ea, sorry, delta ax, and similarly here, theta I, delta ix, and theta h, delta hx, and here also theta times g. So here also you can see 2 to 4, and then we have again 4, 8, 4, 8, 12, and 13, but we know this delta value at each level will be equals to same, will be equals to same. Then we can subtract number of conditions, that is, we have this compatibility of delta cx equals to delta fx equals to delta ix. Similarly, we have delta bx equals to delta ex equals to delta hx. So we have 4 unknowns that can be written in the 2 form or in the 2 terms. So we can subtract here 4 and we will get again 9. So any method you can adopt to find out the value of kinematic indeterminacy. Now the if I modify the question, if you have hinge given at this point, if this is hinge, now they will ask you again to find the value of kinematic indeterminacy. Now find kinematic indeterminacy in this case. If there is a hinge, find the value of kinematic indeterminacy. For this case, you know at point hinge there is a different slope at each direction, at each line. What does that mean? You will get theta eb and theta eh and theta ea and theta ed. These 4 unknown rotations you will get. You already considered in the previous example, that is theta e at a point, but because of hinge you will get additional 3 unknown displacements. You will get 3 unknown displacements, so you have to add these 3 unknown displacement also. So total number of unknown displacement will now equals to 12. So that is the way of doing this, or you can do this by, if you see here, you are getting 4 members meeting at a point. There is 4 member meeting at a point like this. So number of unknown displacements that is going to be increased equals to that, you can derive a formula, that is number of unknown displacement that is going to increase, number of unknown displacements that is going to increase by number of hinge minus 1. Number of unknown displacement increased by number of line meeting at that point, increased by number of line meeting at that point minus 1. These are some of the examples which is being asked in the previous years. So moving to our next question, currently right now we have seen example from the plane frame. We have space frame also. In case of space frame, as I have already told you, we have six number of unknown displacements. We have six number of unknown displacement. Let's see one question from the space frame. Now you have given a space frame. This is our fourth question. Now space, in case of space frame, this is your space frame, say. This is your space frame. Now at any point, the number of unknown displacement at any point is equals to 6, which is our unknown displacement or rotation. Unknown displacement and rotations that are equals to, that is delta x, delta y, delta z, and theta x, theta y, and theta z. At any point, there will be six unknown displacement, that is three translation and three rotation. So in this case, as you have seen, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have four spokes at the top of this structure, or four joints, and at the bottom also we have four joints. So total of we have 8 joints. Now you can derive a formula from which you can calculate the value of kinematic indeterminacy of this structure, which will be equal to 6j minus r. So as j represents the number of joints and r represents the number of spot reactions, in this case we know we have 8 joints, and if we see the total number of reactions, you can find that we have fx, fy, fz, mx, my, and mz. So we also have 6 spot reactions. So at any joint we have 6 spot reaction. So we have total of 4 joints having fixed end, which makes it 24. So we have r value equals to 24, which comes by 6 times 4, that is equals to 24. If we calculate the kinematic indeterminacy now, which will be equals to 6 times of 8 minus 24, which will give us value equals to 24. So these are the kinematic indeterminacy, this is the kinematic indeterminacy of this space frame. So these are the some of the example that is being asked in the IAS examination. Now moving to our next question. You have given this structure. And here a force is being acting. You have given the rigid beam. And you have to tell the kinematic indeterminacy of this structure. Now in this question, you can see that we have given this beam that is equals to rigid beam. This beam is rigid. So, and we know at this point, if this is A, B, C and D, you will get theta A and value of, you will get only theta A, because delta X A and delta Y A value equals to 0. These both value equals to 0. But here at point B, you will get theta B, delta B X and delta B Y. In this direction Bx and this direction By, and in this direction By. But in the question you have given only rigid beam. They didn't talk about the columns. So it may be a change in length of the column. There may be chances that the column length will change. So if the column length changes, then we will have delta By. but delta Vx value will be equals to 0, because here also if you see like this, if you see like here delta BC, sorry, delta CX, this will be delta CX, delta CY and the theta C. Similarly here also we have theta D and delta DX, delta DX. But if we derive the compatibility equation, we will get delta Bx equals to delta Cx, delta Bx equals to delta Cx because of this assumption of rigid plane. So if you calculate the kinematic indeterminacy now, you will get, you have two unknown displacement at this point, two unknown displacement at here also. We know that delta Cx equals to delta Bx. So at two unknown displacement and one compatibility, total of you have five displacements, one is here and two is here, so total we will have eight unknown displacement. We have one compatibility, that is delta Bx equals to delta Cx, and the remaining are the unknowns. So we will have total of eight unknown displacements, that will be, comes out to be 9 minus 1. Total if you count, this will be 9, and one compatibility gives us 8 unknown displacement. So this is the question that is being asked in the previous year. People confuses here the question when they asked in the exam, they think that we have given delta by equals to 0. So this is wrong. You have to see that column length can be changed. So this is the question. Now moving over next question of the day, next question, or say we are moving to our next topic, that is kinematic indeterminacy for truss member. These are frames. Now we will talk about truss member. We know that the truss are the axial load carrying members. We already know that the truss is a axially load carrying members. Now if I put a heading here equals to kinematic indeterminacy for truss member, kinematic indeterminacy for truss. From truss, you know that we have in case of truss two unknown displacements at any point. If you see this structure, if you see this the truss diagram, if this is your truss diagram, say this is a truss, say this is a truss, at any point you know that summation of fx equals to 0 and summation of fy equals to 0. Similarly, at any point there is a possibility of only two displacement, that is delta x and that is delta y. So if you find out the formula for degree of kinematic indeterminacy in case of truss, you will find that its formula will be equals to 2 times of j minus r, that is 2 times of number of joints minus number of spot reactions. So in this case, if you try to calculate the number of unknown displacements, you will find that 2 times, how many joints we have in this truss? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, that is 2 times of 6 minus, and we have 3 spot reaction. This will give us 9 number of kinematic indeterminacy for this truss. Usually in case of trusses, we do not calculate kinematic indeterminacy, because in case of static, if we calculate the static indeterminacy for truss, we find that its value comes out to be lesser than kinematic indeterminacy, means ds comes out to be lesser than kinematic indeterminacy in case of truss. So the whole purpose of finding out indeterminacy is to go for further analysis of that particular structure. If you want to go for further analysis of using this unknown displacement, this will have our lot of time. We will have to spend lot of time to find out the unknown forces in the members. So we do not go by this method unless we have, until we have dx value less than equals to dk, less than equals to dk. So generally for truss member we do not calculate the kinematic indeterminacy. But in exam they will, may ask you to find out the kinematic indeterminacy. For example, this question is being asked in the 2016. You have given this truss and they ask you to find the value of kinematic indeterminacy. Find the value of kinematic indeterminacy if this is the different points. Now you can calculate simply it by 2j minus r. Once you solve it, you will get its value equals to 11. Because you have, how many joints you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you have 7 number of joints and 3 number of spot reaction, which will give you dk value equals to 11. Now this is our plane truss. This is valid for plane truss. This is valid for plane truss. In case of space truss, we will have dk equals to 3j minus r. 3j minus r, that is equal, is in the case of space truss. Space truss, because in space truss we have these three unknown forces, and corresponding to these three we will have three unknown displacements, delta x, delta y and delta z. So we can see from here, in space truss we will have the formula equals to 3j minus r. So now we will see our next topic, that is kinematic indeterminacy for beams. Kinematic indeterminacy for beams. From this part, many questions is being asked in the IAS examination, or you can say any examination, that is state PSC or GATE. You can say kinematic indeterminacy for beams. So consider a beam. Let us assume this is our beam. If this is point A, B and C, now you have to tell the kinematic indeterminacy of this beam. How do you solve this? If you have to calculate the kinematic indeterminacy, you know at this point there is unknown rotation theta B. At this point, unknown rotation and unknown displacement in horizontal direction. So you have these unknown displacements and rotation, but at this point theta A value equals to 0 and delta AX and delta AY, or you can say AH, or let it write down here as delta CX. So these value are already 0. So unknown displacement that will be left will be equals to 3. So dk value comes out to be 3. If we have a fixed port, say we have this fixed port. Now examiner asks you to find the dk value, find its degree of kinematic indeterminacy. You can see we have fixed port, then we have 0 unknown displacements or 0 unknown rotations. So its value, its answer comes out to be 0. Its answer comes out to be 0. This question is asked in the previous year IAS examination. Now the third type of question that is being asked from the beams is, you have given this port. And you have to tell the, dk value. Find the degree of kinematic indeterminacy for this beam. Now you know here you have unknown displacement, theta A, and at point B you have two unknown displacements, theta BA and theta BC, plus you have delta B in vertical direction, that is unknown, that is also unknown to us, and delta B in horizontal direction, that is also unknown to us if say this is the load acting. Similarly, here also we have theta c and delta cx, two unknown displacements, that is one is rotation and one is the linear displacement. So total we have 4 plus 1 plus 2. So total we have 7 unknown displacement in this case. We have dk value equals to 7. So these are the some of the questions that is being asked in the that is being asked from the BIMS in the IAS examination in the previous years. The another question that is being asked from the structures is stability of the beams or stability of any structure that is related to the your stability of structure. Stability of structure. If your degree of static indeterminacy, that is DS, if DS comes out to be less than zero, if degree of static indeterminacy comes out to be less than zero, then the structure is said to be unstable. That is, structure is unstable. But as we already know, ds equals to dsi plus dse. And if we say dsi equals to less than zero, if dsi value less than zero, we cannot talk about its stability. We do not talk about the stability of this structure. We can't say anything about the stability here because dsi value less than zero. But we talk here when the degree of static indeterminacy is equal to zero, not degree of static internal indeterminacy. So there is a difference. And the second condition for structure to be stable is that the reactions should be reactions in the structure should be non-parallel, non-collinear, and non-coplanar. This is the condition for structure to be stable. This is the condition for the structure to be stable. If the reactions are non-parallel, non-collinear and non-coplanar. Now you know collinear means the reactions meeting at a point. If the reactions are meeting at a point, say one reaction is like this, another is like this, and this, when these reactions meet at a point, this gives us collinear point. For structure to be stable, your reaction should be not collinear. For example, if I represent this in spot condition, if I actually represent this in spot condition like this, if we have this spot condition, say this spot condition, if this is a roller and this is another roller, this is another roller, and these are having at the same line, these are having the same line, these are called as collinear points. For structure to be stable, we want our system to be non-collinear. So this is unstable structure. This is our unstable structure. So these are the some of the questions that is being asked from in the previous year IAS examination. I hope you understand this topic of degree of kinematic indeterminacy. So have a nice day. Thank you.